From my perspective, in my opinion, you are one of the innovators of flow. When I think of parkour, and you talked about this in the beginning, it was very static. It was very one movement oriented. When I started, and if you go back and talk to the Lisois, the tracers in Lis, they talk about it was like power moves or like a Kong with two steps. It was things like that. And then slowly this grew into kind of lines. But even when we had lines, as you talked about, people weren't into flips and things like that. I was one of them that was like, no, pure parkour. Like when you're talking about purists and anti-competition, that was me. I was like, they don't have a place in our sport. I respected the AOM because that was this legit thing and a legit brand. But everything else to me was blasphemy. And I wasn't interested in the flips and stuff. And I thought that that was a fad and the parkour was the real energy. I was wrong on most of that, by the way. But the point is that that speaks to a mindset that I don't think was uncommon at the time. And you were one of the people that came along and started to do, I think we had a video for Take Flight called Flow Motion. And you brought this new style. And when I think of flow, I think of you and Foskey. You're the two people I think that added more, that kind of broke the barriers of flow in from kind of the rigid parkour context. And added something to it that no one had seen before. Of course, other innovators like Pasha had their movement, but there was a style of flow that you and Foskey brought, from my perspective, and it's a limited perspective. And so I see you as one of the innovators of flow in the history of the parkour free running journey. How do you respond to that?
I mean, shoot, I'll take it. I don't know. Let me start with, I definitely have a bit of imposter syndrome, without a doubt, and like I always have.
Really?
Yeah, for sure. I have like, it's for a lot of different things. But like, if you look at parkour specifically, right? There was maybe like a 2 year span, 3 years maybe, where I was winning or taking third at like every event. Literally every event that I could go to, I was winning or taking third. And so if you just look at that, right? Just look at like the trophies from that, you'd be like, oh yeah, Joey was one of the more dominant. And I see, even there, I don't even want to say the most dominant, one of the most dominant, like, competitive parkour athletes in that time. And when I look at it, so I have people that'll tell me that. Literally my buddy Chris, who also owns the gym, Somatic, he says it all the time. He's always trying to hype me up. He's like, oh, I know, you're Joey Adrian, like, you're this, you're that. I'm like, nah, man. And so the way that I look at it is not that. The way that I look at it, and I'm assuming this is imposter syndrome, is I got lucky. Literally, I can remember being at every single one of those events, every single one, without fail. And I was like, yeah, I'm not, there's no chance I podium this event. Like, no way. This person's way better. This person's way better. This person's way better. And then event after event after event after event with these people who, in my opinion, were like, if I was a six on a parkour scale, like a skill scale to 10, they were like nines, like that much better than me. And I kept winning, and I kept beating them, and I kept doing better. And everybody's like, oh man, Joey's so good. And I was like, I don't know, man. I swear to God, I think everybody's just kind of choking, or like maybe my style just fit what the judges wanted, or whatever the case may be. But like, however that is, I can never really see myself as somebody that like did that. So you saying that, like being an innovator of flow, doesn't fit in my head. Like in my head, I'm like, nah, I'm just doing my thing. Like, I don't know, because I look back on my videos and I was like taking a bunch of steps and I was doing this and that, and like, so it doesn't, to me, that doesn't ring true. But I don't think it ever would with anything for me. You know what I'm saying? So it's hard to say. It's hard to say. It's hard to say.
Interesting.
It's possible.
Interesting.
It's possible, because I've heard that a few times. Like
Okay.
I went to Kings of the Concrete the last year. Yeah, last year, and met a bunch of athletes that hadn't met before. I know them, like Twin Parkour, Jacru, Jaden Harris, I'd met before. James West, Ellis, who I'd met before, but he was young, and so that was my first time meeting him since Air Whip like 5-6 years ago, all these people, and they were like, yo, Joey, you were like the biggest, you were like my number one, Evan Storm, Evan Leslie, like all these people. Yeah. And I was just like, I look up to them because I'm like, dude, they are some of the best athletes in the world right now. Like, they're the craziest people right now. And they were coming up to me and be like, oh man, you influenced my style so much. Like, I was watching all your videos. Like, you're one of my idols. And I'm just like, nope, that's not me. But hey, thanks, man. Appreciate it. You got somebody else, not me. So it's always weird to hear that. And I, it's hard for that to like sink in for me, but it's cool to hear, and it feels nice, but it doesn't sit like that in my head.